am I?
It's okay. Calm down. Just relax. You're gonna be fine. You got smarter than me. Achieved our objectives.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Black Ops 3 campaign thing, whatever I'm calling it. I don't know. I'm just gonna call it a thing.
Hey! Still with us?
Yeah.
Welcome back.
Thanks.
Taylor.
Yeah.
I am the player. And I have.
Do you know what's happening to you?
Not necessarily.
Am I dreaming?
Well, let's say you are. Why not just go with it, right? After all, you can always wake up.
I mean, yeah. Makes sense.
December 12th, 2054, 7:30 a.m. We're on board a private commuter train headed to the Zurich headquarters of the Coalescence Corporation. Our cargo, prototype for the Winslow Accord Neural Network Initiative. At its core, specialized AI software that's capable of rewriting itself in order to interface with any other system in the world. State-of-the-art stuff back in the day. It'd go on to revolutionize a broad range of military and civilian applications. At least, it would have if the train had reached its destination. At 7:31 a.m., a terrorist group detonated an explosive device on board this train. The incident sent back our robotics program several years. You're here to stop it.
This isn't real. It can't be. What is happening to me?
Right now, you're in a medically induced coma being prepped for surgery. You've got a new bit of hardware inside your head. It's called a direct neural interface, or DNI. I've got one too. That's how I'm able to communicate with you. Your DNI is what connects your mind with your new body and the larger world around you. We're connected.
Okay.
All of this is a simulation inside our minds. And you got a long way to go.
Ah! Scary. So...
RPG! 11:30 a.m., December 11th, 2054. Zurich security forces receive an anonymous tip giving them the location of a hideout the terrorists are using. Unfortunately, the ZSF underestimated the firepower these assholes were packing. They got caught with their pants down, and they took it hard. Outcome? Train go boom. You remember Diaz?
I think so.
It's gonna help get you up to speed on some of the cool new shit you can do.
Communication, brother. We all gotta be in sync.
Yo, Taylor, you're a fucking dick.
He didn't hear shit. If I want to talk to you, the DNI transmits on a closed channel. I don't even have to think about it. But, just so you know, if you ever think about calling Taylor a dick for real, brother, he's gonna mess you up worse than those robots.
Yeah.
All right, let's go see if you can do this without ending up a Swiss cheese like those poor bastards.
Okay. That's fine.
Okay, weapons hot. Weapon
floor. So I was able to change my sights between these things. And I am very happy about it. This is the sight that I need in multiplayer. It's pretty much like one leg. The attachments that I really like. Truth be told, I actually played this before, and then for some reason it ran out of space because I don't have it connected to the right thing. So, I'm back here again, recording it again.
There's never just one route.
So yeah,
high,
that's what I'm
low,
doing.
Left, right. You have different advantages. Your DNI can provide critical info to help you better read the battlefield. Switch to tactical mode.
Okay.
We've
got to get them out of here. I really like this one, so it's good. Bam! I can actually do this. Throwback. This thing can shoot through walls. That's pretty cool.
All right. Use your enhanced mobility. It may take a little getting used to, but your confidence will soon grow. Try it for yourself. I got a hunter says you can do it.
Stay back and snipe a little bit. Cool. Hello.
Attack mode info is synced across the team. One of us sees something, we all see it. Even through cover.
And you can go through there.
Check your ammo.
For this.
Grab more if you need it. Keep moving up!
I know how to do this now. Might have been my fault a little bit. Just a little bit better.
Attack mode info is synced across the team. One of us sees something, we all see it. Even through cover. Check your ammo. Grab more if you need it.
D&I doesn't just help us communicate with each other. It allows us to interact with a variety of computer systems, including pretty much all the basic drone units. Now, bipeds, sophisticated ground units, those are a whole lot trickier, brother. Those sons of bitches got a damn hive mind. You try to process and control all that, your brain is toast.
Yeah, it is.
But these? These fuckers are easy. Go ahead. Back in. Go see what's on the other side of this wall.
Let's go. chose to serve this because I felt like it also shoots rockets.
Yo, you wanna see something cool? Shoot down those bats.
Fresh ammo whenever you see an ammo crate. Last thing you want is to be in a fight with no bullets.
Oh, apparently now.
Suppressors, second level. If you want to get creative, you can use remote hijacking for turrets.
Give me a second. Yep.
Come on! Nice going. That first back up and pair him up. Hideout is just ahead. Once inside, interface with their central console. Pull any data you can.
Okay. Door access. Robot. Oh, God.
Hey, it's okay. It's okay. Just take a second. Take a deep breath in and tell me what happened.
I was back in Ethiopia. The grunts, I lived it all again. What's happening to me?
Shit.
know how your senses can trigger vivid memories? Make you think of sounds, sights, words from songs. Make you think of stuff you haven't thought of in years. D&I can make that a lot more visceral. Little glitches on your optics, little whispers in your ear. The shit happens. The doctor can straighten it out. You just need to recalibrate your meds. Trust me, you're gonna be fine.
So what now?
Oh, right now? You're gonna interface with that console. As soon as you plug in, you'll be able to extract and process the information in a heartbeat.
Got it. They had a man on the inside, at Coalescence. He would have been able to supply them with everything they needed to bypass the security on the train.
The botched assault, man, it took 6 hours for the ZSF to get that information. Outcome?
Signal boom. No boom.
Took you just 6 minutes.
Yeah, it would have been 5. If you hadn't freaked out when you saw those robots.
So what happens now?
Now we go find the son of a bitch.
Teleportation. Don't get too attached to these guys, just by the way. That's why. How did that work? I was hitting Locus.
Tipped off by his terrorist pals. The mole was ready for him. He had heavy-duty combat grunts with him. Once again, Zerg security force got their asses handed to him. Outcome. Train go boom.
We lost him. He slipped away.
You remember Specialist Sarah Hall? She's gonna walk you through the next part. Trust her, do exactly what she says. I trained her myself. She's an intelligence expert from back when that actually meant something.
Before D&I, you had to read books. In the academy, Taylor made me read a lot of them.
Well, some knowledge is worth earning. Appreciating. And that takes time. Time is something we don't always have.
Okay, New Blood. From this point on, the simulation deviates from actual events. Not that it's gonna feel any less real. Use your imagination.
Sending this location to your HUD. Come on now. Pick up the trail. Heads up. Second floor. Nice to see you ate a quitter. I still have line of sight.
This is your only warning.
Our boy's hacking the ZSF Talons. What does that tell you?
He's running scared. Not sitting behind a computer. He could only be controlling them if he's got a DNI too.
You're a smart one, New Blood. I'll give you that. Use that billboard to get over the maglev train. Son of a bitch is still moving. He's heading into Old Zurich. Move.
Out so well, huh? I reckon our suspect has about 15 seconds left before he shakes hands with the Grim Reaper. You can't let that happen. Not before you get the information we need.
I don't think he's in any condition to talk.
He doesn't have to. He has a DNI. buried beneath layers of security protocols, the subject's DNI records cam footage of the user's past experiences. In extreme circumstances, it is possible to extract that information by force. You'll be able to push deep into the subject's memories, their thoughts, even their subconscious. You could learn everything we need to know about the terrorist plans.
I'm sensing a butt coming up somewhere.
You should know. Not only will this procedure be deeply traumatic for the subject, but the associated subconscious interference will leave him brain dead. Dead. Believe me.
I have a feeling this
is a bad way to go.
For somebody to go.
He's a dead man anyway.
And just kill everyone.
Besides, he's a fucking terrorist.
Yeah. Good point. Watching his eyes slowly open. And then. He's dead.
A few minutes ago, you knew nothing. What do you know now?
I know where they are. They're using the old train tunnels to plan their attack.
But you just learned through your DNI took the ZSF weeks to uncover. What do you think I'm gonna say next?
Outcome, train go boom.
Outcome, train go boom.
Called it.
It's good to know you can make tough decisions when you have to. I think it's time we moved on.
Yeah, it's time we moved on. I mean, that would be fine. I mean, we don't have to really, but you know.
We're taking heavy fire! Back up!
ZSF finally tracked down the terrorists to this location. For their sake, they really wish they had.
You're still here, huh? Pity. I bet D has 100 that you'd be dead by now.
Funny man, Specialist Peter Moretti. He's gonna help you understand how much of a badass motherfucker you are now.
Yeah.
Remember, we still don't have the last piece of the puzzle. How in the hell they got the explosives on board the train?
So we're clear? When this is over, you owe me 100. Back to business. As you know, one of the perks of being Black Ops is having access to the latest in experimental weaponry.
Yeah, Black Ops.
Firearms may be your go-to choice for a weapon in a fight. But with D&I, your mind truly is your greatest weapon. Let's do some damage.
Okay. Whatever you say.
That's how you get shit done!
Oh. 10 piece, please. Fries. And ice cream. And everything else on the menu. No, I'm just kidding. Bless you all. Bye. Large. Sorry, guys. Let me get this all sorted out. And we'll
that was close.
Get back. Okay, and we're back. Sorry about that. Okay, we're going.
It's about to go off.
So I'm standing here, watching him. Sorry if I'm talking a little bit quieter than usual. I'm sleeping right next to me right now, so I don't really want to wake him up. Let's. Okay.
got this.
I think that the kit I'm using is going to be pretty good for this next part. This door pad. I might have to go again to go.
They're using smoke grenades.
Switching to your EV helps whenever you're blind, whether in the dark or in the smoke.
I have. I don't need. No thermal sights. I'm just gonna try to go.
Hostile bots! Coming through the wall!
Oh, that's right. You have to do this.
Yeah. down. You may be a badass, but you're not immortal. Bullet to the head will still get you a date with your maker. Fine.
That's how you get shit done!
How's the lower floor?
Make a soldier out of you yet. Good hunting. Interface with that door for me. Come on, don't ruin my good mood now. Just get the door open.
What is this place?
This is where it all went down. The computer over there should give us some insight into how they got the explosives on board. Go interface.
So a nuclear power plant controlled the robots into the that was summoned by the Talons in the entire world. And there was the train. So the train blown up by nuclear reactors. Seems fair enough. The train. There are the robots. There are the nuclear reactors. And then there's no Talon in here, but we can only assume that they, you know, Talon was here.
It's the robots. They hacked the security robots. They brought the explosives on board.
Nuclear power plants. Same thing, really. Sorry, this video's been a little choppy, but you know, best I can do.
You want to hear something ironic?
No.
Reality was, the terrorist attacks actually accelerated the development of the Winslow Accord Neural Network Initiative.
Not ironic.
If it wasn't for the fear of attacks like this one, we probably wouldn't even have the Cyber Soldier program. Hang in there. 7:25. Got about 5 minutes.
Okay.
You've been here before, New Blood. Let's see if you can change history. All robots should be considered hostile. Trust me. I'll consider you as much.
I see the hatch face. Oh, we're going this way.
Watch your flank. They're coming through the windows. Neural network prototype is in the car right below you. It may be shielded by 6 inches of CNT, but that won't mean anything if the bomb goes off. You better pick up the pace. Keep pushing up. You've almost located the explosive.
Really enjoying just hitting everyone over the head with that.
The whole thing's booby-trapped. If I hack it, try to move it, or detach the car, it's gonna blow. It's too much! Even with the computer in my head, there's not enough time!
It's actually very simple.
Wait. This is a maglev trap. If I reverse the polarity on just this car...
no way to stop it and get off the train. Your DNI might show you all the options.
but only you can decide what you're willing to sacrifice. Sometimes, you have to let go.
Okay.
Taylor, how's our patient?
As good as can be expected.
I expect better. You should know that.
Welcome back. Being prepped for surgery now. It's gonna be okay. Hendrix wasn't even injured on the mission. He volunteered for this.
He's such a nice guy, and the blanket's not even covering half of him, so I'll let it slide for such a touching moment.
The increasing prevalence of drones and combat robots has significantly reduced the reliance on human infantry.
As I said before, we have no further comment to make at this time. We will continue to explore avenues of diplomatic negotiations.
The WA have denied sending troops to the region, stating that they are still seeking a diplomatic solution to the standoff.
We are coordinating closely with our allies in order to provide tactical support where needed.
How long have we been doing this, Hendrix?
5 years, give or take.
Sounds about right. You ever think about where we're going next?
Nope. You know me. I just go with the flow.
And that's what that done. We got a lot of different stuff. Pretty cool. So, that's where we get to go now. This is our home. In here we can go here.
Hendrix. Where are we again?
Singapore, one of my favorite places, apart from all the ones I actually like. We've got an appointment with our new LNO inside the quarantine zone.
Oh, yeah. This is a CIA op. This is their safe house.
Glad you remember. I hope you also remember how I feel about the CIA watching over our every move.
They're always watching, Hendrix. You should know that. I think you're just getting grumpier with age.
Yep. So in here, you can go and, like, do special missions. Not, like, story missions, but, like, different things. I can't jump, so I have to use the stairs. Here's where you can edit your loadouts. Here's where you can design your weapons, build weapons with things and paint jobs. And cyber cores. These things are what help you... This is system paralysis, the one that you get effect 5 targets simultaneously, basically shuts them down for a little bit. Then you unlock all these using these things up here, fabrication tokens. I use control. I don't use any of these. I just use control. There's a way to use all three of them, but you know, I'm not all about that. Here is where you set up. And here is where you select a mission to go to. Select a mission, all this stuff, performance, how you did on it, what you like, special things that you could have done on it, and then like what it's actually gonna send you to do. So yeah, that's gonna do it for the first episode. I will see you guys the next time, where we will be tackling the next mission called In Darkness.